हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अरेंथ इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल सोलापुर ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन। वी आर स्टार्टेड अवर फर्स्ट लेसन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7 सब्जेक्ट जनरल साइंस, द लिविंग वर्ल्ड अडेप्टेशंस एंड क्लासिफिकेशन पार्ट 2। इन पार्ट 1 वी लर्न डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ प्लांट्स and in animals and the definition of adaptation. Now in this video we are going to see the adaptations in plants and animals. Adaptations in aquatic plants. Some of the aquatic plants are firmly rooted in the soil at the bottom of the water bodies. Their stems are submerged while leaves and flowers float on the surface. You can see in picture also. However, some plants are entirely afloat. Their roots are not anchored in the soil. Adaptations in aquatic plants. The surface of leaves and stems of many aquatic plants are covered with a waxy layer. Leaves of some aquatic plants are thin and slender like a ribbon. This shape helps them to withstand fast current of water. Air spaces in stems and petals of aquatic plants are useful for floating in water. Next point is adaptations in desert plants. Now there is one activity that you have to try. Take two potted plants, one a cactus and the other a leafy plant. Tie plastic bags loosely around the leaves of these plants and keep them in sunlight for early in the morning. In the afternoon, bring those pots into the classroom and observe them. Has the same quantity of water collected in both bags? So the answer is no. The leafy plant has more water drops because of the evaporation of water. So desert plants are either leafless or their leaves are like small needles. You can see in picture also, or have been modified into thorns. As a result, they lose very little water by evaporation. So they can evaporate little water instead of leafy plants. So the stem stores water and food and is therefore fleshy. The stems are green as they perform photosynthesis in the absence of leaves. Their roots penetrate deep into the soil and some roots spread away into the soil in search of water. There is a thick layer of waxy substance on the stem of these plants too. Now adaptations in plants of snowy region. Plants of snowy regions mainly include conifers like deodar and pine. These trees are conical in shape due to their sloping branches. You can see in picture also. In the heavy snowfall and extreme cold in this region, their conical shape prevents the snow from accumulating on the tree and the thick bark helps the tree to withstand the cold. Now adaptations in plants of forest region. A variety of plants, trees, shrubs and herbs are found in forest. These plants compete amongst themselves for sunlight. Hence, trees grow tall to get sunlight and climbers and vines grow to a great height with the support of trees. Now, adaptations in grassland plants. Diverse type of bushes and grasses are found in the grassland. Fibrous roots of grasses prevent soil erosion. Forests in the equatorial region are dense. Animals like tiger, elephants, and deer can remain hidden in these grasses. Now, adaptation for ingestion of food in plants. Fungi do not have chlorophyll and cannot perform photosynthesis. That it cannot make their own food. They obtain food from starchy foodstuffs like bakri and bread. They have root-like fibers for absorption of food. Adaptation for injections of food in plants. Plants need nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium for growth. Plants that grow in soil which is deficient in nitrogen, like Drosera, Sundew, Venus flytrap, pitcher plant, etc., fulfill their need for nitrogen by consuming insects. Adaptation are seen in these plants which serves to attract insects and hold them captive. Adaptation in aquatic animals. Now, aquatic animals show modified structure of body. Tapering spindle-shaped body with scales and fins for swimming. Respiration by gills, air bladders within the body for floating. Adaptation in desert animals. Scarcity of water. Scarcity means less amount of water is present. Has resulted into adaptations in the body of animals. Burrowing in deep earth. Characteristics in animals. Long legs with flat soles. Folds of skin over the nostrils. Long and thick eyelashes. Thick skin to conserve water in the body. Next point. Adaptation in forest and grassland animals. Now they are classified into two types, carnivorous animals, herbivorous animals. Now the legs of carnivorous animals are strong legs with sharp claws, and in herbivorous animals, long tapering legs with strong hooves. Now the eyes of carnivorous animals front of head, and the eyes of herbivorous animals are below the forehead. Teeth in carnivorous animal pointed canines. And in herbivorous, strong molars. Ears are small in carnivorous animals, and in herbivorous animals, long and freely moving. For example of carnivorous animals are wild dog, fox, tiger, and lion. And the examples of herbivorous animals are deer, antelope. Adaptation in animals of snowy region. Long, thick hair on the skin, white or silver body color. Example, yak, polar bear, white fox, silver fox, mountain goat, etc. These are the snowy region animals. Adaptation in aerial animals, that is in air. Spindle shaped body of birds that minimize their resistance of air while flying. Featherings covering the body. Forelegs modified into wings. Air sacs in the body to increase buoyancy. Hollow bones making body light in weight and adapted for flying. Adaptations in reptiles. Snakes creep with the help of scales on their skin. Some reptiles use their muscles for creeping. Example, house lizard, garden lizard, crocodile, etc. So these are the adaptations in animals. Thank you, students, for watching this video.